Hello students, my name is Shweta, your English teacher, and today I'm going to teach you Deep Water by William O. Douglas. See, I have made a PDF and I'll discuss these points to you so that you will have a great understanding of the entire chapter. Deep Water is already given in a periodical perhaps. If not, then I have been informed by your teacher to teach this chapter only. So let us start Deep Water by William O. Douglas. Now first of all, before starting the chapter, let me tell you that what are the values that actually William O. Douglas wanted to teach us through this chapter. It's a personal experience of Mr. Douglas. And why he is sharing his personal experience with us, because there are certain values that he particularly wants to inculcate in everyone. So let us see what are the values that this chapter has raised. The first one is determination. You all are well aware with this word that if anyone is determined, then if he or she will get the proper environment, then she or he can do anything, or she or he can achieve anything in her or his life. So determination. Next is optimism. What happens that if we fail for few times, then a negativity always surrounds us and we lose hope, we give up. But if you're optimistic, that if you have decided that yes, I will do this, then certainly you will. Optimism is a necessary part. It is not only only thing. Remember, if you're not doing anything and you're very optimistic and you're thinking that everything will be available to you, then it's stupidity. Remember, everything is related to one or other. If you are optimistic and you are not showing your effort, you don't have endurance, you don't have determination, and the most important thing is you are not working in that area or way to achieve that, then being optimist only will not help you. So optimism is very important, but with work. Okay. Now perseverance. Perseverance means what? Perseverance means continuously you are trying, you are facing failures, but you didn't lose hope. Okay, you still have hope, never give up. Perseverance means continuously trying. Diligence means if you are doing something with a dull mindset and you are not showing your 100% effort, then definitely somewhere or there else you will lack. But if you are highly enthusiastic, diligent to achieve something, it will help you. Openness to challenges. Now, what are openness to challenges? See, there are some people who always endure. Endure means to bardasht karna. So, who always endure and they are ready to face any type of challenge. So, openness to challenges, new challenges. This, yes, it will be my next target and I will do this. There are some people who are very sly. They love to sit at a backside and they hate challenges, or you can say that sloth bear. You have read this word like them. Courage. Again, courage is very important, that yes, I can do this and I'll take the chance. Persistence, endurance, etc. If you will see that what are the values that has been raised in this chapter, you will get a glimpse that all are interlinked or related. Means having only one of it will not help you, but combination of it will definitely help you, along with hard work. Remember, hard work or smart work according to situation, because these days if you work very hard and it will work definitely, but now it's time to work smartly. So smart work, hard work depends according to situation. So determination, optimism, perseverance, diligence, openness to challenges, courage, persistence, endurance, etc. Well, moving further, before moving further, let us get a bit idea that who is Mr. William Douglas. William Douglas, one of the most popular and powerful American Supreme Court Chief Justices in the history. Now, definitely, if any Tom, Dick, or Harry will write anything about his or her life, definitely we are not going to pay any attention. Okay. Well, this is known to you for the first time that he belongs to America. So, American people, of course, we love to read that, yes, he is very successful. What are the challenges that he has faced in his life? Trust me, there are several people who have worked with high principle in their life, but no one is ready to hear them. But when we hear Mahatma Gandhi, that yes, he has stolen something and he has written, penned down that in his book, then we create a great or giant image of him. So, he was also a very famous person. He was American Supreme Court Chief Justices in the history, very powerful, and had an enemy since the childhood. He tried to defeat this enemy. Now, what type of enemy? Any person, anything, any fear? What is that enemy? Let us see. He tried to defeat this enemy in all possible ways. First, he tried to overcome this enemy all by himself, and later with the help of a trainer. Though he took years to defeat the enemy, finally, Douglas killed his enemy. He was not arrested or sentenced for this murder, not because he himself was the Chief Justice, but because his murdered enemy was his fear of water. See, I have presented this just to create an interest. You don't have to write that he has an enemy and it is just another way of saying something. Okay, so what was the deep enemy? His enemy was his fear of water. His fear of water, hydrophobic or something like that. Everyone has something fear, and if you are able to defeat that fear in your life, then you are a great achiever. So let us discuss what are the points. William Douglas had great passion for water. Very, very, very contrast. Fear of water, passion of water. Means he has a great passion of water, that yes, one day I'll do this, but at the same time he has a great fear. He longed to learn swimming. Okay, passion for water is there, but fear is also coming parallelly. He longed to learn swimming. When he was 3 or 4 years, he was taken to a beach in California by his father. Remember, I suggest you, or rather I instruct you, to go through line by line at your home. If you face any problem in any paragraph, you can consult it to me. But it is very important because there are several steps. Okay, and the question will come for the first time, where did, what was his first encounter with water? So whether it was California, YMCA pool, or what is that? What was that? So I request you, instruct you, or whatever you wish to understand. I just want you to read the chapter line by line. So when he was 3 or 4 years, he was taken to a beach in California by his father. Now what happened? For the first time, the fear knocked him. While surfing on the shore, a huge wave knocked him. He feared water. That was his childhood fear. Definitely, one or without a bad experience, it is difficult for anyone to create any image. If you have any bad experience, definitely that's why you are trying to avoid something. So his first encounter with water was at California beach, where he was taken by his father. And first wave, when that wave actually hit him or knocked him, he fell down, and that somewhere else in his mind, it created fear. Now the next, after some years, he longed to swim in the Yakima River, but his mother warned against that idea. The Yakima River is treacherous. Now see what happened, children, generally, that I want to interrupt you here. That suppose we understand that yes, our children has great fear for this, and at the same time, if we have the passion for this also, so what we do, we always say negative things to him, that please do not go over there, the river is very treacherous, several people died over there. So he is already hydrophobic. He has a very bad experience, first bad experience when he was 3 or 4 years old. And now when he again started, he started to showing his interest, then what happened? Mother warned him that yes, you are going to Yakima River. No, don't go over there. The river is very treacherous. So he was already in fear, and this very small bonus fear was given by her mother. Perhaps I'm against such type of situation, that if I find that yes, someone is specially very much against, or he is not able to endure something, then I'll boost, or everyone should boost him or her up instead of warning. Now see, then he found the YMCA pool, the safest place for swimming. See, now he thought that yes, I had a great passion for water. I had a great passion for water. I can survive near shores. He cannot survive near shores because he has a bad experience. Now, when it comes to river, mother warned him. Now, he was looking for the safest place, that I have to complete it. I have to overcome my fear. But how? My mother warned me to go to riverside. Bad experience related to beach. Now, what to do? So, the safest place is swimming pool. From there, he started that if I'll be able to swim properly, then definitely further or later on, I'll go to beachside or river. So, then he founded the YMCA pool, the safest place for swimming. Its deepest end was 6 feet deep. You can imagine, 6 feet deep. The bottom was tiled. The drop water, the deep part was gradual. Water was clean and there were other children swimming. Now, what happened? Again, an incident happened over here. See, he went to the pool and started swimming by imitating other boys. Rather, he was sitting over there and just trying to paddling or imitating. He was imitating others. Then an incident occurred. One day, while waiting for the other boys to come, a big boy threw him into the deepest end of the water. Of course, someone wanted to cut a joke. So what he did? He threw him away in the water. He threw him away. What are you doing over here? You are here to swim now. Why are you sitting like this? Okay, you have a great fear of water. Dhakel diya. Now what happened? See, already he had a great fear for water. Now that bully boy, there are of course such type of boys available in every marketplace. So what he did, he threw him away. And that 6 feet was very deep for a newcomer, especially for a hydrophobic person. That 6 feet was very deep for that boy or Mr. Douglas, especially when he is hydrophobic. So one day while waiting for other boys to come, a big boy threw him into the deepest end of water. Now, Douglas had the courage to face the situation. He went down and down with the hope to reach the bottom to make a big leap upward. Now, there the incident happened. He went down and down and he thought that yes, today I'll manage to come. And when you will read it line by line in chapter, you will be surprised that how he has mentioned each and every detail, that what was his feeling. For a flinch of moment, he thought that no, I'm gone. Go went gone ho gaya bhai sabka. So for a very small moment, he thought that. Douglas had the courage to face the situation. He went down and down with the hope to reach the bottom to make a big leap upward. 3 times he went down, and on the 3rd time, he lost consciousness and almost died. Well, I've written this like simply, but when you will read the chapter, definitely you will get the glimpse that what was his condition. Douglas gives a vivid description of death, which is peaceful. And now see, this is a very bad thing of a writer or a philosopher. Out of everything, they create philosophies. Out of everything, they create philosophies. If you'll ask a philosopher if they will see birds in the sky, again, they'll start their philosophy. Overthinking, okay. So, of course, although he's a Supreme Court Chief Justice, one of the famous Supreme Court Chief Justice, but somewhere or the else, he had a writer hidden in his heart. So, he has given a vivid experience or description of death, which is peaceful. You know what happened, children, that a moment arrives when we face a lot of challenges. When we face a lot of challenges, then there are certain times where we pray for death. We think that yes, death is much more peaceful than this, or the struggle through which I'm going through. So we pray for death. We think that yes, death is much more peaceful than the situation we are going through. So it happens, and of course he is a literature man, he drew philosophy from there, and he has given a great philosophy that death is peaceful. Douglas's body floated on the surface. Someone dragged him out of the water and provided first aid. He thought that no, he is no more, but of course he was at swimming pool and different people were there. They helped him, they dragged him out from the swimming pool, and anyhow they managed to give him air and it worked further. After this incident, Douglas tried to avoid water and water sports as much as possible. So these all incident, YMCA pool, mother threatening him for Yakima River or California Beach. These all are his childhood experiences. And since then, he has a great determination that now onwards, I'm not going to touch water. Okay. Now onwards, I'm not going to touch water. When he grew up, water began to tempt him again. Now, before this, everything that we discussed was related to his childhood. Now, when he grew up, water began to tempt him again. Tempt means, those who do not understand, whenever you see any chocolate lovers, whenever you see any cake lovers, whenever you see any pen for pen lovers, whenever you see any sport bike, whenever you see a sport bike lovers or whatever, then you start getting tempting. Ah, mere paas aa jaa. Ya main uske paas chala jaun. So when he grew up, water began to tempt him again. He got a trainer and learned swimming. Now in the second phase, the entire description is only about his fellows, his determination, different situation, his hard work, not smart work, rather hard work that he did to achieve success. So he took training in different pool, rivers, lakes, swam, and then he finally, whether he is able to conquer that or not, we will see it in the next class. So I want you to read up to that part where he has shared his childhood experiences. See that question where he has given a very good description of death, how death is peaceful, what happened at YMCA pool, okay, Yakima River, California Beach, and these things. In next class, we will see the second part, or we will just, definitely not second part, rather, what happened, how did he manage, and why I'm telling you to read the chapter, because from this chapter, of course, we all know that these days in this pandemic time, subjective questions are difficult to be asked. So, what is very important that you need to learn, I'll suggest you need to learn, because see, we are not Americans, okay, we are not Americans. So in India, Ganga Nadi mein kood ke sikha, Yamuna Nadi mein sikha, yahan pe sikha, it is very easy for us to remember. But because these all rivers belongs to America, so you need to learn the name of those rivers where he actually learned, and different type of strokes, whatever That's why you have to read the chapter properly. So we'll see this in our next class, what type of person his instructor was, whether instructor was helpful to him, or finally he has to conquer his fear by his own. So we'll see all these things. Till then, you have to read everything line by line, and if you face any problem, then contact me. That's all for today's class. Thank you.